Well, I look at the health care reform bill as an important first step, and it did some very, very good things, but it certainly needs improvement. But I want to talk for a moment about some of the good things it did do. 18,000 New Hampshire citizens with pre-existing conditions are now going to be able to get health insurance coverage. They won't be able to be denied because of those pre-existing conditions. Over 100,000 New Hampshire middle-class families will qualify for tax credits that will enable them to buy desperately needed health insurance. It does away with lifetime caps on coverage. It closes the donut hole for seniors. It permits families to keep their adult children on their health insurance through the age of 26. So it does some very important things. I think my concerns are, first of all, that we need to keep an eye on cost. We need to make sure that it is paid for. The Congressional Budget Office said it was going to bring down the deficit by $100 billion in the first 10 years and $1 trillion over the second 10 years. We need to make sure that that promise is kept and that controls are kept in place to make sure that happens. And I do think that we want to consider revisiting the question of a public option. I think it would provide much needed competition to the private insurance industry and a fallback to others who might otherwise fall through the cracks. But for those who say they want to repeal health care, which is a lot of what we hear from the other side, I'd like to ask them, which of those reforms that I just mentioned, pre-existing conditions, lifetime caps, closing the donut hole for seniors, which of those important reforms do they want to throw out the window?